Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. I am so excited to continue on Nancy Drew. This is the second episode of season 3, and the description is The Journey of the Dangerous Mind. And it looks like we're going to be dealing more with the Frozen Heart murders. As we know from the first episode, we learned about the Frozen Heart murders because their hearts were literally removed from their chest, and they met Temperance Hudson. Ugh, I cannot talk. We met Temperance Hudson, who basically kind of set everything in motion for the Drew crew, basically saying that, you know, one will betray their true love, one will lose themselves, one will, you know, pretty much give in to romance, stuff like that. So she gave some kind of ominous predictions to pretty much set the pace for the rest of the season. And so we had a little bit of Nace in there too, and of course they're going to continue throughout the season. And you know, Carson was kind of kept in the dark, so by the end of the episode, he was kind of like, wait, what's going on? And of course, Nancy also did not get into Columbia University like she wanted to. So, George and Nick got engaged as well. So, I'm excited to get going on episode 2. I hope you are excited as well. You know, from posts I've seen on Facebook and Instagram and stuff, it sounds like this season was a hell of a ride, you know? And that's what makes a show great, when there's all these twists and turns and they keep you on your toes and keep you guessing. So, are you ready? Let's get started. Classical music while he's taking care of the dead bodies. Hey, why not? In a job like that, you probably have to have a sense of humor.
Hey. No. Whatever you're into, I don't care. You can't be here. Who let you in?
Nancy still has her key card. Dude, I'm so sorry, you guys. I really thought that Connor would want our help figuring out if our murderer was a human or a supernatural baddie.
Yeah, like a supernatural entity that came after his son last month.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and we bought bagels.
She said it was open-ended, which is why she said to me mind the historical site to wash away.
Yeah, blood-bathing rituals, I highly doubt you have an actual tip.
You're right. It's better than a tip. I have a way to solve these murders.
Here we go. Seven minutes in, and we already have a little bit established. Obviously, we're going to find out what happened with George's ring. You know, she said rock and metal, which, you know, is correct. A diamond is the hardest stone, so yeah, it does make sense that it would basically be rock. But I'm glad to see that she's freaking out about it, because, you know, with George, you can never tell exactly what her emotions are, you know, because she's even said that she is kind of cold and everything, and she has to be. But you know, it's nice to see her kind of softening a bit. And, you know, Nancy, with being a community liaison, I'm wondering if she's getting paid for it. I would think she is. It doesn't seem like it would be an internship, but who knows. They may have said it in the last episode and I missed it. And, of course, Ace and Nick were there at the autopsy, and doesn't seem like they learned a whole lot. But we've basically seen the whole cast in the first, like, 7 minutes, which is good. You know, sometimes it takes a little bit before one of the cast members is introduced for the episode, so it's kind of nice that they were all basically within, like, the first 2 minutes. It looks like Ryan is living there now, which makes sense because I think he basically was disowned by the Hudson family. So, yeah, it makes sense that he and Carson are, and Nancy are all kind of sharing a house. And it also makes sense since they are both her fathers, you know, she would want to live with her fathers, so.
I saw the three-fingered man the night of your friend's engagement.
How do you know about the suspect?
I overheard those college boys yammering on about their suspects once could be our own.
Right,
yeah, definitely do not trust her.
If he did, my way, and keep Vic away from me until we do. I refuse to see the look on his face if he finds out I lost it. It'll absolutely kill him.
We'll go next here. Distract him.
No, we can go.
Oh, God, what's she got?
Hey, hi. What's all this?
Oh, yeah, we're going to test ways the killer could have frozen Dustin's heart using pig hearts that Ace got from Frank the Butcher.
Okay, well, we have customers in today, and we don't want to scare them, so why don't you go through the back door?
Yeah, good idea.
Yeah, it's just a little fly.
Thanks.
It's a bone.
How would they be allowed to do this in the back of a restaurant?
Dry ice. We can flash
that
freeze.
That is so unsanitary.
Number two, using liquid nitrogen.
Well, you ever done this before?
No. But I'll watch a YouTube video.
Okay, it's gotta be accurate then.
Flash freezing is actually a misnomer. It takes about 20 minutes.
Definitely, she shouldn't be trusting Temperance. You know, she obviously has an agenda. Could it be that maybe it is a different killer and she does want to get the crime solved? Could be. But I think it's because if that is the case, she obviously has her own agenda. You know, it's not going to be anything like, I'm going to solve it because I'm a nice witch and I want to protect my youngest descendant, you know. Not gonna be anything like that. But it could be that there is another killer, which is not associated with her, and she does want to help solve it for her own selfish gains. And it could also be that this killer is working with her. Obviously, you never can tell, you know. That's, again, the thing about this show is that there's all these twists and turns that her. And like I was saying about the guys with the freezer, it's like, wouldn't that be incredibly unsanitary what they're doing? I mean, granted, they are putting these hearts in liquid nitrogen, which would definitely freeze any and all germs that were a part of it. But still, I'm just like, that seems still kind of unsanitary. At least bringing it in, you know. And then George allowing them to do it, of course, is also kind of like, you would allow it to happen? Yeah. But, you know, it's George's restaurant. She can basically do what she wants. Valid.
And now we have a lead on the man who infiltrated my home.
You could say thank you.
For roofing me?
Pass.
At least she did give you some clue.
Protection from?
I can't, I can probably figure out the sack on my own.
Wonder where the ring did go.
Hearts are different from Dustin's heart.
Because
they
okay.
Not use liquid nitrogen or dry ice. Well, on to heart number 3.
Oh, Ace.
What happened?
It is not Ace's day.
Can you glue that up?
Yeah.
Uh-oh.
You don't have to stay with me. It's not your fault that I slipped in a puddle of melted heart ice.
Yeah. Well, it is my fault a little. I performed a protection ritual on you, but I must have messed it up because you keep getting hurt.
Hey, what's up?
Hey, Ryan, can you give me a ride to 4660 Cascade Avenue?
So obviously Nancy's going to be the one who finds the clues that others miss, obviously, because that's what she does, being a detective. And obviously they're setting it up that she's going to start dating that FBI guy. And then that will kind of, I think, be the catalyst for Ace to tell her how he feels. That's how I see that going. So that part, you know, is in a way good because it'll kind of get him off his ass, I think. Will he actually tell her? I don't know. We'll find out. But I think it's going to release some feelings and he's going to be a little more open about them. And I'm not sure why he's being targeted, if it has to do with Bobsy or whatnot. I kind of missed that. Again, that might have been the last episode, and since I reacted to that like a week ago, my brain is a little fuzzy on it. But, you know, I'll find out. I can always go back and review. And I think Bess, she's trying magic, so it looks like we may end up having a witch in our midst, at least later.
I don't know what we're really doing here. I'm not going to flip out like some other dads would.
White collar crime, a parking ticket scam. Can you stay in the car? Just be my lookout.
But do you have permission?
Sorry, what's that, Carson?
Okay.
He's being a father.
Yes. I'll wait here in the car.
He's being a father. You're gonna get yourself killed, Nancy. Enjoy death.
Doing
that, but
can I just bug you for a tiny favor? I'm looking for a candle.
Oh, it's a minefield. Well, I'm gonna say get down, but if it's a minefield, that may not be a good idea. Oh boy. Well, I knew something was gonna happen, that there was gonna be some sort of trap in that location, and that, you know, it's not like she's gonna be able to sneak around without any problem, you know. I mean, that would have been way too easy. But, you know, she's like, oh, he's destroying evidence. And she just runs in. And I'm like, this is not a smart idea. You know, that's one thing about Nancy, is she gets this idea. And I know that she's doing it to try to help people and protect people. But it's kind of like, you need to stop and think about the consequences of your actions. You know, if you go ahead and you do this, one, you could end up dead. Two, Ryan is outside, he could end up dead because he'll come in looking for you and then he gets killed. Three, you're basically putting a target on your friends' backs. So then guess what? They might end up dead. So she runs head first into these things. And again, I know it's because she's trying to solve a murder and protect her friends and her loved ones and everything. And I totally get that. But again, she doesn't always think about everything. You know, she doesn't think about all of the consequences that come along with her decision. And I remember on the previews, Carson says something like that. He says, "You take all of us with you." So I don't know if that's this episode or the next one coming up, but I know Carson does say something similar to that. And then Nick, you know, mentioning to George about the engagement ring, and I'm thinking to myself, he's a millionaire, because we found that out in season one or season two. Again, I don't remember. But yeah, he's like a legit millionaire, so he can afford to get her another ring. If it's just rock and metal, it's something that can easily be replaced. You know, and I get the whole symbolism of it. You know, she said, "I look down at it and it's our future and our life." And it's like, yeah, it is, you know, but at the same time, it is also something that can be replaced. While Nick cannot be replaced and you cannot be replaced, the ring can be. So, and then Bess talking about that candle. So I'm wondering if there might be a battle between Temperance and Bess, since Bess is kind of looking a bit into magic and everything. And since she was mentioning about like her relative, one of the Marvins, who kind of battled with Temperance in the past. So I'm wondering if they're maybe going to go head to head or something in some sort of witchy battle, which would be really cool. You know, in the previous couple seasons, Bess was always my favorite, and I think she still is, but I am kind of leaning a little more towards Ace, too. But, you know, it can vary from episode to episode. Sometimes there's an episode where Nick is my favorite, or George, or Ace, or whoever. You know? But let's keep going. Uh-oh. Where is that? Is that Agent Park? Yeah, it's Agent Park. Okay.
Hey, Nancy's inside! Sorry, I need to stay right where you are. Is she okay? Is she inside?
In a suspect's house in Nancy's phone.
They're pipe bombs.
Yeah, you should have led with that.
Yeah.
Oh, I thought you were a detective. I'm going to tone of my voice. Yeah, profiler.
Well, not that good. Your weight is holding down the trigger. We don't know how sensitive that release plate is.
Of course she would sneeze. Now, of course, we have a very interesting moment.
Are we okay?
I think so. Nope. Hopefully now.
I think we are now.
And how my entry was illegal and evidence was destroyed and now trots in the wind and we don't have any other leads and we don't even know what his real name is.
Hey.
Ace is the one you want. Don't do this. Ace is the one you want, Nancy. I mean, hell, Ace would have risked his life for her, too. And again, you know, with the TV show, my friend and I were actually just discussing this the other day, that, you know, they have to do that, of course, in TV shows. Set it up. You know, you can't get the characters who are supposed to be together. You can't get them together right away because then there's no story. Or you get them together, but then, yeah, you have stuff happen where there's other factors and they break up and then, of course, eventually do get back together. It's the same trope that you see in pretty much every TV show. And at the time of this recording, Nancy Drew has not been renewed for season 4. So keeping fingers crossed for that. But, you know, if they do renew it for season 4, then hopefully we will get Nace. Now, you never know. They may renew it for season 4 and say this is going to be the last season. And if they do, then they'll probably go full balls to the wall on us actually getting Nace. But if there is a possibility there could be a season 5, they'll of course go ahead and continue to kind of play with it if we don't get it by the end of season 3. I have a suspicion that they're going to kind of dangle it in front of us like a carrot, but not completely give it to us. But you never know. We may have something happen with that. But again, it's the whole same trope that you see in everything nowadays. You know, it's always, they have to have conflict and stuff like that, and because, you know, it creates drama and it really tortures the audience and the fans. Will they, won't they, will they, won't they, will they, won't they. You know, it's something that has gone back since X-Files, maybe even before that. You know, in X-Files, they were like geniuses at doing that, where they'd give you a little bit and then take it away. Give you a little bit and take it away. And, you know, like I said, that might have been kind of the catalyst. I'm sure it's happened before, but that one I know was a major one and was the one that gave us the term shipper. But that was, I think, a major one for kind of doing all this kind of slow burn and build up and everything before finally giving the audience what they actually want. Best to go and get the candle herself.
No, new friends. Thank you. Your friends don't understand what you're capable of.
Don't trust your potential.
But you, well, you feel it. I know what that's like.
One word, no.
Well, I did try one of Martha's rituals, which didn't work, and I don't know why, because...
Yeah, I think it's probably weird for you and your sisters that I'm going to be a part of the family now. So, if you...
She's not even listening.
You ever want to talk about anything, I'm here. Always where you least expect it.
Am I in trouble?
Yes.
No.
Or into a fire or off a cliff. You take me with you.
That's
you take
what?
Everyone who loves you with you.
Running? After all these years, I'm...
Too fucking bad. Shouldn't have dragged him into it.
Bring life. Carry this energy into the night.
Mm-hmm.
Oh my God.
Best Marvin. I think you're destined for greatness.
The dead cat. So she brought the cat back. I like how they're going to make Bess a witch. I also am kind of like, you know, with it too. So I kind of have mixed feelings, you know. I like that they'll have, like, a powerful witch who can help them with spells and everything. But I also am kind of like, seems kind of typical, like, yeah, of course they're going to go ahead and do that. So, mixed feelings. I'm sure I'll come around to Bess being a witch probably by next episode. And I also like how Nick is trying to be a part of the family, you know, that he was commenting about wanting to get to know them and everything. And the girls, of course, were kind of, I think, on the fence about whether or not they were going to let him in. But, you know, he is going to prove himself to be a great member of the family and definitely important and someone that they can rely on. You know, like Charlie was saying, Victoria would leave every time there was a new guy, and so of course she would think that George's gonna do that. And as George said, I'm not her, you know? I'll always be here, and yeah, now you've got Nick too. So Nick is going to take his role very seriously, yeah, of uncle. He's, or brother-in-law, I guess, because those are her siblings, so brother-in-law. You know, he's going to care about them and be there. So, you know, I like that he was stepping up and trying to, you know, trying to take that first step. Ace said he'd give Mosby a ride, but yeah, obviously he knows that there's some shady shit going on, and so now we're going to find out what's going on with him. I'm guessing that guy's going to be the catalyst for Ace and Amanda to break up, because that's Amanda's father, right? Again, it's been a while since I saw season 2, so I don't remember everything. Anyways, that's my react to episode 2 of season 3 of Nancy Drew. If you enjoyed this react, please hit the like button and subscribe for more content. Hit that notification bell to be notified of future Nancy Drew reacts. Please check out some of my other videos. I've got shows like Chucky and Doctor Who also here on my channel. If you are watching this on YouTube, this has probably been edited down, so head over to Rumble to catch the complete version. And if you're on Rumble and you want to check out the edited one, pop on over to YouTube and check it out. Definitely go ahead and follow me on Instagram, and if you can, support me on Patreon, because I would love to be able to continue to do these videos. I don't get paid unless, of course, you guys help out. And I know times are tough right now, and I totally understand. If you can support, it'd be great. If you can't, just thank you for being here in the video. Special shout out, of course, to my editor, Captain Factory. She's the one who makes these videos the way they are, makes them perfect and watchable. I have a link to her account on Fiverr down in the description. Go and check her out and hire her for your needs, but don't take her away from me. I'll see you in my next video. Bye.